Right now, only 2.5 million BTC sit on exchanges, down from 2.7 million during the last dip to $74,000. That's a supply shock in real time. From $74,000 to over $100,000 in weeks, that's not luck, that's pure demand.
Hi guys, welcome to part 2. In case you missed the first one, you can check it out over here. In this part, we will learn 3 core concepts of 3D camera, text animation, and match cuts. I hope you have a wonderful time and let's get started. In step 1, let's create the base. We will start with a new 4K composition. Let's add a background to it. Go to new, go to solid. I'm going to name it as BG. Keep the colors black and just press on OK. Now in the reel, even though you see this as 3D, at the base, these are simple 2 rectangles. Let's create these 2 rectangles and then we'll add camera on top of it. To create this, firstly come over here. Let's select our rectangle tool. Ensure that no layer is selected. Click on fill. Let's keep it as gradient. Similarly, the stroke, it should be gradient as well. Now coming to our composition, let's create a rectangle like this. If you press on V, you'll get these 2 points. You can use them to turn this into a nice gradient. Similarly, for the gradient of the stroke, let's take these 2 small points, keep one over here and keep the other one somewhere over here at the bottom. So if I come outside over here, see we have got the rectangle similar to the one in our demo video. If you want to change any of the dimensions, you can simply click on the layer and holding these points, you can reduce or increase the size. Once you're happy with the rectangle, simply go over here. Let's name this as rectangle 1. Let's take a copy of this by pressing Command D and we'll call it as rectangle 2. Coming over here, let's place this on the side. Perfect. Selecting both the layers by holding Shift. Go to Align over here and align it on the center. Perfect. This takes care of our step 1. In step 2, let's add the lines. The line should start somewhere over here. For that, again going to the top, let's select our pen tool. Let's make the first point over here. Holding Shift so that we get the straight line. Again hold Shift and make a line over here. Let's go to Fill. Keep it as None. Again, the stroke, we'll keep this as solid stroke. Once you're happy with the line, coming over here, let's rename this as line 1. Again, selecting the line, going to the top in the add, let's add the trim paths. This way, we can easily animate the line. Let's open the trim path, add a keyframe in end, let's reduce this to around 20%. Let's go to 1 second. At this point, let's bring this to 100%. At the start, it will be over here. And then at around 1 second, it will end at 100%. Let's select both the keyframes and press F9. At 1 second, we also need to add the text 2.5 million, something like this. And we also need to add this small dot. Let's quickly do that. We select all and press U to close them. Let's zoom in, holding this. I'm just going to add the ellipse tool. Let's create a small dot like this. This point should appear when the line reaches over here. So let's see, it reaches at this point. So we can cut it before that. Let's see. Perfect. At the same time, over here, we can add the text 2.5 million. Before that, also I'm going to add the audio for our reference. We'll just keep it over here at the bottom. 2.5 comes somewhere over here. So we'll add the text. For that, let's go to text. Let's write 2.5 million. Select all. Let's make the color as white. Let's keep it at the top. I'll just make this as bold. Reduce the size. Let's skip it over here. Let's animate this quickly. Firstly, press S for scale. Let's scale this down to 0. Add a keyframe. Going a little ahead, at this point, we'll bring this back to 100%. Let's say this. Then again, at around 4 seconds, we have the other text. Down from 2.7 million. At that point, we also had to add the text 2.7 million. Simply take a copy of this by pressing Command D. We'll call this as 2.7 million. Let's click the layer. Let's bring it and keep it on this side. Press on U. Set both the keyframes and drag them somewhere over here. Select the text, double click and turn this 5 into 7. Perfect. This way we have completed all the layers required for our rectangle 1. So let's select the layers by pressing Command. Perfect. And the rectangle 1. Let's pre-compose it. Again, to avoid any confusions, we'll just call it as rectangle 1. This takes care of our step 2. In step 3, let's animate the second rectangle. All we need to do is simply create this line that reaches till 74,000 and later on, at this point, it reaches from 74,000 all the way to the top and reaches 100k. Let's create this line first and then we'll animate it. Going over here, select our paint tool, ensure that no layer is selected. Let's make a point over here. Oh, we forgot. The fill should be none and the stroke can be 2. Perfect. Select the point again. Make a curved line. It should be over here like this. Let's place it something like this. Let's see it. How does it look? Yeah, this is looking great. I made a few minor changes, but this is looking great. Now let's animate this line. We'll call this as line 2. Again, selecting the layer. Going to the top, we'll select the trim paths. Let's open this. Maybe around at 5.5 seconds. We'll keep the end at 0. Add a keyframe. Till 6 seconds or 6.2 seconds. Let's bring this down. Maybe somewhere till 28%. Let's click elsewhere. No, we'll just need to keep it little. Select both the keyframes and press F9. Okay, when it says during the last dip to 74,000, at that point, let's add a text 74,000 as well. Text, go to the text. Add a text over here. $74,000. Let's zoom in. It will be over here. Let's quickly animate it. Press on P as well as T. Add a keyframe in both of them. Let's place them somewhere over here. At this point, add two more keyframes. Go to the first ones. Select the position. Position should be a little down, as well as the opacity should be 0. So it will look something like this. Perfect. Press F9. From 74 till 100k. So let's complete the line from over here till 30 seconds. For that, let's select the line. Add a keyframe over here. Over 100k. So let's increase the line. Perfect. Let's see this.
Time from $74,000 to over 100.
Again, one small thing we need to do. When it says over 100,000, we need to add the text over here. Again, going to the top. Let's add a text over here. 100,000. Let's place it over here. This takes care of all the text that we need to add in the second rectangle as well. Now let's quickly select the layers, similar to how we did for rectangle 1. Selecting the layers and rectangle 2. Let's pre-compose them. I'm just again going to call it as rectangle 2 and press on OK. Perfect. This gives us a clean timeline. Now in step 4, we are going to make everything 3D. Let's make rectangle 1 and rectangle 2 as 3D. Right click over here, add a null object. We'll call this as the controller. Again, right click. Let's add a camera. I'm just going to keep it as maybe 35mm and press on OK. Keep the controller on the top. Make it 3D as well and connect the camera to the controller. Perfect. Now let's come to the start. So now if you see in our demo video, at the start, we have a position like this. Later on, it moves from this to the next rectangle. At that time, we also get a focus light. To keep our rectangle something like this, let's go to the top and select our orbit around tool. Let's orbit it like this. Next, select the other tool. We can keep it over here. And using our dolly 2x cursor tool, we can bring it near to our camera. Perfect, let's keep it like this. Once you're happy with your selection, select your controller. Press P to open up position and also R to open up the rotation keyframes. Add a keyframe position, spacing from over here 2.5 million. For that, I'm just going to move it on the right like this. Let's keep the keyframe over here. Also, let's add a keyframe in Y. At 2 seconds, I want to rotate it a bit so that we get an constant movement. Maybe something like 5% also looks fine. Perfect. This looks great. When you set down from 2.7, at that time, our position should also be on the left. Before that, let's go to 3 seconds or little earlier than that. Let's add a keyframe. This can be at this point. And then around here, let's keep this all the way on this side. So if I play this,
down from 2.7.
Perfect. But again, at this point, we can make few changes in the X rotation and the Y rotation. So let's add keyframes in X. Also over here. Going to the next one. Let's rotate it a bit. Perfect. Also, why we can rotate like this. Let's see this.
BTC sit on exchanges down from 2.7.
Perfect. Now selecting all these keyframes, press F9.
Exchanges down from 2.7.
Perfect. So at this point, when it says during the last dip, I'll quickly move this camera from over here to the second rectangle. So for that, we'll do one thing. At this point, it can stay. Then at 6 seconds, we have to quickly pan this and move it on this side, like this. Let's see this.
7 million during the last dip.
Perfect. Again, we have to make few changes at this point. When it shows 74, at that time, we have to break the camera. So at around 7 seconds, when we see this text, let's see this. See in a demo, it shows 74 and it breaks the camera. Following the exact same thing, select this layer, holding option and the right square bracket, let's break the layer. So this takes care of our step 5. In step 6, let's add the spotlight. To add it, just right click over here, go to new and let's add the light. Everything can remain the same, just press on OK. Let's keep it somewhere over here. Let's zoom out. Press on P. Let's adjust the light position. Okay. Even you can shift it somewhere over here. So let's see, let's zoom out more. So at the start, we can keep it like this. Then later on, maybe somewhere over here, let's add a position, keyframe. Quickly at this point, let's zoom in. Let's keep this keyframe at this point. So that
0.7 during the last dip to 7.
So at this point, let's reveal this. Now, if I play this, we can see. We are able to reveal this white color. Something very similar, which is happening over here, right? When this gets revealed, we also have this white color. So using the spotlight, you can add the subtle lights on the rectangles. In case you feel that the text is too small, you can simply go inside these rectangles and make them bigger. Perfect. We will stop over here and cover rest of the shot in part 3. If you faced any issues or have any doubts, let me know in the comments. And if you want to learn how to edit like other pro YouTubers, you can check out the playlist.